Ladies and gentlemen, we're here not just to mourn the passing of some great friends, but to celebrate their life on this earth and look back with fondness on the time we spent with them. Somebody who, without ever calling any attention to themselves or hogging the spotlight, saved thousands of Android developers from writing line upon line of boilerplate code, but now they've moved on to the great deprecation warning in the sky. I'm talking, of course, about Base Game Activity and Game Helper, who were taken away from us, some might say, a bit too soon, by a change list just a few weeks ago. Yes, if you've been following Google Play game services on Android for a while, you may have noticed that our sample code has recently changed. Whereas before, all of our sample applications inherited from Base Game Activity, a class that used Game Helper to do a lot of heavy lifting, both of these classes have disappeared from our sample apps and have also vanished from our documentation, almost as if they never existed in the first place. So what happened? Well, you see, back when Google Play Game Services first launched, Android applications were great for using Google services, as long as you only need to use one of them. But Play Games, as you'll recall, used three: the Play Games API, the Plus API, and the App State API. And it turns out that in the old days, the process for using more than one API client was something that we in the engineering field like to refer to as, and this is a technical term, a bit of a mess. You see, to connect the player properly to Google Play Games, the first thing you had to do was, you know, create your three clients, and you'd collect the scopes you need and call connect on the games client. So far, so good, right? Well, then if that connection failed, because, you know, your player might need to sign in, it's actually no big deal. Just remember where we are, so that once the player has signed in, we do know where to continue from. Then, of course, you need to do the same thing with the Plus client. Can't do these things in the other order, incidentally, unless we want to present our user with like multiple sign-in dialog boxes, which is never really a good idea. Oh, of course, if that Plus client fails, you'll definitely need to handle that as well. Oh, but if it fails a second time because the user said, I don't want to sign in, you'll need to resolve this by disconnecting the Plus client first and then the games client. You don't want to do that in the wrong order because that would put your game in a bad state, and you certainly don't want that. Of course, if all that worked, you could do the whole thing again with the App State client with all the same rules as before, but only do this after you've connected your other clients. And if it fails a second time, disconnect everything in the reverse order, App State Plus, and then games. So easy, right? So this is basically why Game Helper and Base Game Activity existed. The multiple state machine was the same for every project, and so rather than have hundreds of developers write the same boilerplate code, we decided to make it would make more sense to create a reusable component for anybody to use. So we abstracted all this away into a Game Helper class, composited that into Base Game Activity, and then had Base Game Activity call all the relevant methods. All your game needed to do was inherit from Base Game Activity, and we did most of the setup work for you. But then, in early 2014, something magical happened. The Play Services team released the Google API client, a drastic improvement in the way these APIs work. This is actually a really nice chunk of code. It's very pretty. It's beautiful and wondrous. But with the introduction of the Google API client, if you wanted to use multiple Google services at once, like, you know, games, plus save games, or even Drive or YouTube, the Google API client handles it all for you. Here's how it works. Step one, you're going to create a builder. Step two, add your APIs and your scopes. Step three, add some callback listeners. Don't forget to call build, and then call connect on this new client, and you're pretty much done. You'll catch sign-in problems in your on-connection failed callback. You can analyze the code here, and depending on the error code you get back, you could show a sign-in dialog if necessary. In your on-connect listener, you would start making API calls. And in your activities on-stop method, you would call disconnect, and the Google API client will properly disconnect all of your services. And you've got a nice, straightforward API client with some great error handling, just the way nature, or at least our engineering team, intended. But with that, there was a whole lot less stuff that the Game Helper classes suddenly needed to do for you. And its role gradually transitioned from helpful class that did lots of heavy lifting behind the scenes to yet another layer of code you needed to worry about and keep in sync with, like, a few helpful bits still remaining. So what we've done is we've taken those remaining helpful bits and converted them into static methods in a new class called BaseGameUtils. And then we have deprecated both Game Helper and BaseGameActivity and are no longer using them in any of our sample applications. So what does this all mean for you? Well, for any of your existing code, nothing. Any code that you have that's currently working will continue to work. If for some reason, however, you decide you need to replace your Base Game Activity or Game Helper classes with the versions we have archived on GitHub, you're going to see some deprecation warnings in the log. But for the rest of you, all this means is that when you're digging around in our sample apps or our documentation, you find yourself saying, wait a second, I could have sworn there used to be a whole helper class around here somewhere that I was supposed to use. Am I going crazy? Well, no, you're not going crazy, at least not for that reason. We've just dropped these classes from our samples and our docs. Now, if you want to see this code in action, my advice would be to take a look at Trivial Quest, our extremely simple, some might say trivial, sample application that demonstrates the proper way to sign in and handle connections using the Google API service. And you can always review our documentation, which has now been updated to support our new Google API client world. And so with that, we finally bid adieu to Base Game Activity and Game Helper. Gone from this world, but still in our hut. Wait, what? What do you mean they're not dead? They're on a beach in Miami? Yeah, you know, this is something you could have brought to my attention before I bought all these flowers. Well, all right, to heck with this then. I'm changing out of this suit. This thing's itchy. So, who's in the coffin anyway? You know what? Never mind. Don't tell me. I don't want to know.